with 10 to shoot. A lot of time for FEU. Masyadong malakas yung pasa. But Anthony Hargrove recovering. Garcia for three. No!
In and out, and that's a hard smack on the head.
Yep, an unsportsmanlike foul.
Good call by the ref there, even though it was not intentional to go for the head, but he did hit all head.
Colomia readily apologizes to Deng. That is big. By the way, we enter the last 2 minutes. Simple lang magipon sa PS Bank. Open a savings account now.
Ang layo naman sa bola. Tsaka may follow through to pull back. If you're gonna inadvertently hit the head, you're still trying to go for the ball, that's fine. But there was a follow through and he pulled it back. He pulled the head. Napapa UFC na ako eh. Pulled the head back.
Well, two things. Good on Jaron Deng for not reacting.
Yep.
And another thing is Mike Colomia has no reputation of hurting other players.
Yes, as well.
No, I'm just saying that
correct
as a fact.
But true.
That being said, it's a good sportsman.
It is a good call. It's a right call.
And Jaron Deng again knocking down free throws here. 69-66. FEU and LaSalle dragging each other into the deep waters of this game once again.
So 7 out of 10 now. Jaron Deng today.
FEU is 8-1 when they lead after 3 quarters. As you look at Revilla, who might be our Appleton most improved player this season. Watch out. The averages are 5.53, but he's got 14-7. He's played big in the last 2 games for LaSalle. And he has the ball right now. Hesitation, he loses it. And it will stay with LaSalle with 9.
I don't know about these isolation plays for LaSalle.
Uh-huh.
You know, they were doing well before with the pick and rolls, ball swing, ball movement, but...
And that's why Coach Nuno,
yep.
I think they're going to review that last call. Let's see first, Ms. McDonald's instant slow-mo, spice up your day with the new McSpicy.
From that angle,
yeah,
slow-mo na yun, huh? Yep, your refs are requesting for another one.
We have to see this repeatedly. We'll see. Because remember, we are within the 2 minute mark, the last 2 minutes, so
we can review every single yes out of bounds play. That's close.
Very close. We'll look at it again.
Parang left hand ni LA, no? Parang LA's left hand. That was the last touch.
They're
actually looking at our monitors here. So they want another angle here. They're requesting another replay. Here we go. So maybe it looked like, to me, the left hand of LA was the last touch. It looks like LA's last touch.
Last touch on green down. I think they're going to reverse it to FEU.
So the ref patiently looked at it over and over again.
He didn't even offer them a donut.
How
rude.
Pero pumasok sa bahay. Kain muna.
69-66. A minute and 35 to play. It is gut check time for LaSalle and FEU. Garcia, the veteran. Risky pass again.
Tough pass into a guy who's not known to have good hands. I don't see Hargrove. Bobbled the reception.
3-point lead and ball possession for LaSalle. And the veteran L.A. Revilla handling it. Go to Deng with 7. Deng against Bello. Deng for 3! And FEU gets possession with under a minute to play. Romeo now. Romeo from way
out. Oh, man. That's a long shot with, what, 19 seconds on the shot clock.
There's some questionable shots from both sides,
yep.
DJ.
Nerves are getting into the play now.
I think so.
Hindi na masyado na pag-iisipan yung ginagawa nila. No need to foul for FEU. One possession game.
Revilla fakes the pass. Goes out to Deng with 9 to shoot. Deng draws closer. Deng.
Good defense by Bello.
Revilla with 5 to shoot. Romeo is up in his grill. Perkins turns around. The rebound, scramble, and the ball will go to FEU. What a sequence the last 4 times for both teams.
I'm holding my breath. I'm tense here.
They need to
refs
review
want
it
a double check. Refs want a double check. So we're asking our directors to see a replay of that last out-of-bounds play. Pero yung kasama nila, mukhang ready mag-inbound. So, eto na. Here we go. Here's that turnaround by Perkins to beat the shot clock buzzer.
Yep. Another Ooh. Tough one.
It looks like Norbert was the last touch, so the refs incurring their call altogether.
Okay. The Tamaraws will keep possession. 23 seconds remaining. LaSalle with a three-point lead there. 23 seconds.
FEU boom has a timeout remaining, so they don't need a three yet. Here's a closer look. There you go, Norbert.
Norbert Torres. Yeah, with the last touch.
Good close-up by our director.
McDonald Simpson, slow-mo, spice up your day with
everything. RR jacks up the three. Boom.
Oh, wow. And now they need to foul.
Now they need to foul.
And they
do.
Foul Revilla.
Wow, no LaSalle. Need for three there, but he had a look. RR had a look there. I wouldn't say wide open, but he had a look. He didn't have to force it with a hand in his face.
LaSalle is 13 seconds away from going back to the finals, something that has happened since 2008. DJ, remember what I told you in the first quarter, FEU's 10 wins, di pa tapos to, ah?
Not yet.
But FEU's 10 wins, 70 points.
Na mauna sa 70 points.
Oh.
And they're
all
only at 66 right now.
Yep.
They're only at 66 right now. If you like those, trivias with the statistics.
Revilla needs one to put pressure on FEU here.
To make it a two-possession game.
And he does.
So FEU will call the last timeout.
This is not a one-ball game.
Biggest timeout here for Coach Nash Rosella this season so far. Let's see how he can keep his composure and call a good play for them.
We'll take a break, TJ. We'll come right back right away here at the Mall of Asia Arena. Well, we were eavesdropping during the timeout, during the commercial break, and Coach Nash Rosella had a very controlled timeout. DJ, your thoughts?
Well, it's winning time for FEU. And you're going to see some options here for them. You can either go to RR Garcia or Terrence Romeo here. Remember, this is one of their smallest lineups, so it's going to be tough to get an offensive rebound. Tinanggal pa si Hargrove. It's Belo and Pogoy are their backcourt.
And now,
the frontcourt, by the way.
Coach Juno makes a substitution of his own.
Adjusting to it, adjusting to the smaller lineup.
Yep. Tapos to replace Torres.
He pulls out Norbert Torres. And interestingly, LaSalle has a foul to give. LaSalle has one foul to give here before they get the penalty.
I love Perk as he approaches Mac Belo, says, sup.
He trash talking. What's up, lang sabi niya.
Romeo, Belo for three.
Wow.
No,
RR was open, and Terrence
but
didn't
it's their
see
ball.
Him.
It's still their ball.
RR was
1.
Wide open
was
on the left
he?
Side. He just did not see him. Well, he was covered by the double team.
Wala rin
siyang passing angle. Mas libre yung passing angle niya kay Belo.
And that's why they wanted Tampos there for that quick double on Romeo. 7.1, Coach Nash and the coaching staff right now at the edge of their seats. Nakatayo na mga tao dito sa Mall of Asia Arena. They wanted a quick two, they got it. They're going to go for a foul, obviously.
But LaSalle has a timeout.
That's right.
Interesting, LaSalle didn't use their foul to give.
So we'll take a break. Back in a moment. FEU, the last team to overcome a twice-to-beat disadvantage right now on the ropes with 5.8. They're going to foul for sure.
They're going to foul for sure, and Coach Junior Sala reminded his boys to hold on to the ball well because they're going to foul with an attempt to steal it as well.
Perkins double team and foul.
So Perkins will go to the line.
LaSalle as a team is 19 of 33.
Perkins today 1 out of 3.
Perkins is 1 out of 3. In the fourth quarter, LaSalle is 6 out of 10 as a team. It is a 2-point lead. FEU doesn't have a timeout.
No more timeouts for FEU, but 4.4 seconds is enough time to get a rebound or an inbound if he makes a second one and still get a good 3-point shot. Maybe not a layup anymore, but if they get a good long pass, it is possible. But that's, if you're LaSalle, that's one thing you're going to deny. You're going to deny a layup. Big free throws for Perkins here.
His first year. And he feels it right away.
Yep.
4.4. LaSalle has outscored FEU 18-12 in this quarter after being down 4 at the turn of the quarter. Perkins.
Oh. Trickles in. Just trickles in.
Nanuksupa.
4 seconds to go.
Romeo.
Not looking to pass. Oh, that's a foul
that's
to give.
That's a foul to give.
But I wouldn't want to do that because he was going to heave it from half court. Now you give him a chance to get an inbounds at a closer angle with 1.6 time for a catch, fake, dribble, and shoot even.
Hirap talaga
mag-decision. Let him heave it at half court.
Mahirap minsan yeah. mag-decision talaga.
Yun na nga.
Sa mga ganyang pagkakataon.
So yan, makaka-target po yung inbounder na mas malapit na tira.
And they go to Romeo right away. No! LaSalle goes back to the finals on the strength of a 9-game winning streak.
Unbelievable streak for LaSalle, the longest streak this season so far.
An RCBC Savings Bank life-changing move. RCBC Savings Bank, my loans, it's life-changing. This was crucial, TJ.
This is huge to beat the shot clock buzzer. To make it, to avoid a turnover there.
And this is the part where you see players on the floor celebrate and the others bowing their heads in heartbreak. And some of the players for FEU, a couple of them graduating, Mendoza and Garcia. Congratulations, LaSalle, the winning team, Bonchon of the game, powered by Bonchon Chicken, Team Bonchon for the win.